Okay, so the next topic that we have to study is about the functions of marketing. What are the different activities or things that the marketing management has to perform? Marketing is related to the exchange of goods and services through its medium. The goods and services are brought to the place of consumption. This satisfies the needs of the customers. The following activities are undertaken in respect of the exchange of goods and services. So there are so many activities that are connected with the exchange of goods and services. Okay, so these are the functions of marketing. The first one is called gathering and analyzing market information. So first of all, when a company wants to When a company wants to start a production, or when the company wants to have a new product, then the company wants to gather information from the people, from the customers, what is their need. Okay, so there are a few questions that they have to find answer for that. Like, what do the customers want? And in what quantity, at what price, when do they want it? What kind of advertisement do they like? What do they want? Where do they want? What kind of distribution system they like. Okay, so there are different type of questions that the companies has to ask. So they have to find out answer for these questions, and if they are able to find out proper answer for these questions, then they are able to gather information from the people properly. After collecting the information from the people, collecting the information from the public, they do market planning. In order to achieve the objective of an organization with regard to its marketing, the marketers chalks out his marketing plan. For example, a company has a 25% of market share of a particular product. The company wants to raise it into 40%. In order to achieve this objective, the marketer has to operate a plan in respect of the level of production and the promotion efforts. It will be decided as to who will do what, when and how. To do this is known as a marketing planning. So marketing planning means that, see, like if a company is there, so the company is having different shares are there. See, like if you consider like a mobile market, okay, so if you consider about a mobile, then there are so many companies are there. Okay, but now in India we can say that MI is considered as the leading company, okay, or the leading brand, which is selling the highest number of mobile phones. Okay, so we can say around 40 to 50% of the total mobile sold in India is produced by MI company. Okay, and there are also other companies are there, like Oppo is there, Samsung is there, Vivo is there, so many companies are there. So they have different shares are there in their market, isn't it? So we can say like one company is giving like some 10% shares. I mean, the 10% of the, like imagine that if total 100 mobiles are sold, out of that 10 mobiles are of this particular company. But they want to increase this one into maybe like a 15% or 20%. So every company wants to be the topmost in their region, and they want to increase this one. So in order to increase this one, what they have to do? They have to do market planning. Okay, so they have to make so many procedures. So they should understand what is the need of the customers, why their products are not demanded like other companies' product. Okay, so they will see, and it may be because of the like the price, it may be because of the qualities provided, or different type of things will be there. Okay, so depending on that, they will try to develop their products, and they will do different type of advertising methods, they will do different type of promotional methods, so that they will be able to achieve their target. Then next one, product designing and development. Product designing plays an important role in product selling. The company whose product is better and attractively designed sells more than the product of a company whose design happens to be weak and unattractive. So see, like the product design and the shape, you know, see, like if you purchase a product, like imagine biscuits. Earlier, as I told you, like the Parle-G biscuit was there, it was in like a rectangular shape, you know, and that was the only shape available. But now, if you compare, if you see the market, you can find there are biscuit in oval shape, there are circle shape, heart shape, the diamond shape, mad angle, you know, so many different shapes are there. Okay, and you can see the cover of the product also. So like if you like a namkeen or a biscuits or not this like a chips, okay, so packet of chips you can see, it is like a big bag, big air is there inside that, like potato chips if you are purchasing. In that very big packet is there, and they use very attractive colors like orange color, red color, yellow color, all these attractive colors. They will not make and produce any chips product or any biscuit is covered with a black cover. Have you seen? Or white color? Have you seen? Not there. Any company is not producing. They will, why? Because it is not an attractive color. If you make it in a black color, even though like Oreo biscuit is coming in a black, but Oreo black biscuit is there, but its cover is not black. So, you know, internal one is a black one, but outside they are using blue color. Attractive colors are used. Attractive colors, attractive designs, attractive labels are used. Why they are using it? Because when you see a product, you should get attracted towards that product. Then only you will purchase it. Yes, you know. Even though if the product is having very good quality, but if it is not much attractive, people will not purchase. Do you understand? Once if you are using it, after that you may continue using. But most of the time, so the product has to be in attractive. So there should be use attractive color, attractive outside appearance, and labeling, all these type of things have to be there. Okay, very attractive designs and what should be there. Some products are made in different shapes also, like soap and roll. If you can see, soaps are there. Earlier only is that square shape or rectangular shape of soaps were there. Now the oval shape is there. It is looking like mango shape, apple shape, different shapes soaps and all are coming. So some soaps are coming with the like some teddy bear shape and all. You know, especially for children and all, there are some soaps and all. So there are so many different varieties of designs are there. So these designs and so they will decide what type of design and what type of color, what type of packaging should be there for the product. The next one is called as a standardization and the grading. Standardization refers to determining of a standard regarding size, quality, design, weight, color, raw material to be used, etc. in respect of a particular product. By doing so, it is ascertained that the given product will have some peculiarities. This way, sale is made possible on the basis of samples. Mostly, it is the practice that the traders look at the samples and place a purchases order for a large quantity of the product concerned. The basis of it is goods supplied conform to the same standard as shown in the sample. So they have to maintain some standard, you know. So like a standard product, if you purchase a product, like a branded products are there. If you purchase like 100 packet of a biscuit, if you purchase, you will find that in every 100 packet same number of products will be there. Like same number, like if in one packet if 10 biscuits are there, if you take 10 packets, all in 10 packets, 10 each biscuits will be there, you know. And the shape or the color or design of the product will be also similar. There is no any difference. Like in one product, if one shape, another one is another shape, it is not like that. You know, so all the ones will be having same quality, same size, same shape, same color, everything. So that standard they will maintain. And if that company, if it is produced which is not up to the standard, then they will not be making it available for selling. They will make a new product. Okay, so every product they will maintain a proper standard, proper quality will be maintained. Okay, and agricultural products and so on, they make it into different grades, like A grade, B grade, C grade, like that, different grade products are there. And their price also will be different according to their grades. Okay, the next one is called packaging and labeling. Packaging aims at providing avoiding breakage, damage, destruction, etc. of the goods during transmit. Storage. Packaging facilitate handling, lifting, conveying of goods. Many a time customers demand goods in different quantities. It necessities special packaging. Packaging materials includes bottles, canister, plastic bags, tin or wooden boxes, jute bags, etc. Okay. Label is a slip which is found on the product on the package, providing all the information regarding the product and its producers. This can either be in the front of a cover or a seal. For example, the name of the medicine on the bottle along with the manufacturer's name, the formula used making the medicine, all these things. So like a packing. See, like if you take, see, like imagine that you are going to purchase a hand sanitizer, you know. So hand sanitizer, if you are getting in a normal bottle and you have to open this one and you have to pour it and use it, So that type of things is not that much comfortable. But now the sanitizers are coming, it is just like a spray bottle, which is there, one button is there on the top, you press on that and it will be spraying on the hand, isn't it? Or perfumes are there, perfumes, if you imagine that if a perfume is coming in a bottle with a cap and all, and you have to open it and apply it on your hand and apply anywhere, so then it will not be looking nice, isn't it? So because you feel laughing because it is not comfortable one, it is not easy to use. Or a hand wash. Or like eyeliner, you know. So eyeliner, if it is coming in a dibba, you have to put it and apply it such a way. If it is coming, then it will not be attractive. Okay. So each and every product is made in such a way. The packing is made in such a way that it will be comfortable for the people to use it. Yes, you know. First of all, it will give protection to the product, like toothpaste. Yes, you know. Toothpaste is coming in such a way that all the products are made, the bottles or the pack is made in such a way that it will be very much easier and comfortable for the people to use. Is it not? So accordingly, the products are made. And they are packed for the purpose of protecting the product from damaging. Is it not? So on the way of transportation, or like some biscuits and all are coming, like in that again, like if you open the biscuit, there is like a plastic tray is kept there. You know, so and each biscuit is kept on each, like one, like round things are there, and in that they are keeping. You know. So that if it is falling down, then also this biscuit will not break. Okay, so such a way they are packing. So if any kind of while transporting or any other type of means are there, and at that time it should not get any kind of problems. Okay, and the labeling means that if there is a sticker pasted on that product, you know, so there will be a sticker and it will be displaying the name of the product. Where this product is manufactured, when the product was manufactured, the price of the product, how much gram of product is there, all the details regarding what are the ingredients of the product used there, all the details about the product will be displayed on that. Is it not? Have you noticed? Every products are having labels or sticker pasted on that. Okay, and that will be showing the label of that. And like clothes and all, there is like a price tag is there, one like a sticker like thing is there, or one card will be there and it will be hanging on that. So on that, the name of the brand, name of the manufacturer, and the price of the product, all these details will be mentioned there. Okay, mostly it is pasted on the cover itself, most of the products are there, but other type of products, it will be just like other label will be there. So all these type of things are coming in the category of labeling. The next one, what are you doing here? Branding. Every producer, seller wants that his product should have a special identity in the market. In order to realize his wish, he has to give a name to his product which has to be distinct from other companies. Giving a distinct name to one's product is called branding. Thus, the objective of branding is to show that the product of a given company are different from that of the competitors. See, for example, there are like brands. So we purchase a product of different brand, isn't it? Like if you are going for purchasing a mobile phone, like MI is there, Samsung is there, or Xiaomi is there, or different brands are there. You know, watch, there are so many different brands are there. If you consider like car, there are also so many brands are there. So we purchase the product based on the brand value. You know, if you are going to purchase a mobile phone and you are ready to pay like some 50,000 rupees or 1 lakh rupees for purchasing a mobile phone, for an Apple phone, why? Because it is of the value, you know. The value is of the brand value, you know. So this is a particular brand. This will be only, though this we consider that when you are using this product, it shows that I am using a very high branded product. So it will give you a prestige issue, you know. So it will give you a prestige, and based on that we are purchasing the product. Okay, each and every product we purchase because of the value of the brand. Okay, so the name of the product, every name. So you might have seen that they will make the name with a very easy name, you know. So which can be easily pronounced. Very complicated names if you are using for the brands, then people will not be able to pronounce it or remember it. Okay, so that is called as a branding. The next one, customer support service. Customer is the king of a market. Therefore, it is one of the chief functions of a marketer to offer every possible help to the customers. A marketer offers primarily the following services, like after sales services, technical services, maintenance services, handling customers complaints, credit facilities, product related information. So if you purchase a product on that, always most of the product they will have, they will be printed a toll free number there, isn't it? And they will also have written there that we are happy to listen to you or happy to receive your complaints, isn't it? So you, there is a customer care number will be printed on the product, and if you have any clarifications or any complaints or any kind of problems, you can contact this number. Okay, a number is given and they are appointed some people for listening to the complaints. Okay, so this is the service that the company is providing. So if you are having any complaints or a problem, they are ready to listen, isn't it? Or like after sale service is there, like if you purchase a product and see, like if you purchase a fridge or washing machine or any type of products like a car or things like that, then they will come and install it in your home, isn't it? So already the company executives, they will come and like if you are purchasing a TV, then that antenna and all these things are there, so they have to be connected, so they will come and connect it into your home and give, isn't it? And if a car like thing is there, so if any kind of problems are there related to that, then that they will repair it, isn't it? So they will be repairing these things, and if any kind of problems are there, so they will give guarantee, warranty, all these things. So these are all the services provided to us, isn't it? Then next one is pricing of the products. The price of the product is very much important, isn't it? So we look at the product, at what price the product are there, isn't it? If we are having getting product based on the quality, that price should be there. So we have to see to it that what is the purchasing power of the people, which type of people are using, what is the target market, and considering all these type of things into mind, we have to make decide the price of the product, fixing of the price. Then next one is called a promotion. Promotion means the information, informing the customers about the product of the company and encouraging them to buy these products. These are four methods of promotion: advertising, personal selling, sales promotion, and publicity. So promotion means that making the people aware about the product, okay, informing the people about the product, what is the quality of the product, or what are the name of the product, all this type of information will be provided to the customers, and also motivating them, simply not giving information, but motivating them to purchase the product. Okay, so you have seen there are four methods are there. First one is advertisement. So there are so many advertising methods are there, you have seen already advertisements are there. Sales promotions are there. Okay, sales promotion means that like buy one get one free offer, or like 20% discount, or 20% free cash back offer, or a price gift offer. So many type of offers are there. All these type of things are coming in the sales promotion. Then personal selling and publicity, all these different methods are used for promotion. The next one is about a physical distribution. Under this function of marketing, the decision about carrying things from the place of production to the place of consumption is taken into account. To accomplish this task, decision about four factors are taken: transportation, inventory, warehousing, and order processing. Physical distribution by taking things at the right place and at the right time creates time and place utility. So physical distribution means that as I told you, you are getting products from Haraya market, but almost all of these products are not manufactured in Haraya market. It is produced in different parts of the world. And if you are purchasing winter clothes now, but this winter clothes is not manufactured in 1 week or 2 weeks time. Okay, it is manufactured almost a few months before itself. So when a product is manufactured in one place, that product has to be made it available to our market. Okay, so for that purpose, physical distribution is used. So there is a transportation required, storage facility is required, order processing is required, all these type of activities are required for that. Next we have to study about the transportation. Production, sale and consumption, all the three activities need not be at the same place. Had it been so, transportation of goods for physical distribution would have become irrelevant. But generally it is not possible. Production is carried out at one place, sale at another place, and consumption at yet another place. Transport facility is needed for the produced goods to reach to the hands of the customers. So transportation, as I already told you, like a product is manufactured in one place, it is sold in another place, and used in some other place. Okay, imagine that if a product is produced in Delhi and you are purchasing it from Basti or from Gorakhpur, and you have to bring this product to your home and you have to use it, isn't it? So the manufacturing place is Delhi. The sale is taking place in Gorakhpur, and you are using it in Haryana. Do you understand? So there are these three things are taken place in the three different places. So the product which is manufactured in Delhi has to be transported to Gorakhpur for making it available for sales. Then after purchasing the product from Gorakhpur, you have to transport this product to your home. You know, so like if you are purchasing a TV from Gorakhpur, so you have to transport this product from Gorakhpur to your house. You know, so that transportation is very much important there. The next one is storage or warehousing. These are time lag between the purchase of a product of goods and their sale. It is very essential to store the goods at a safe place during this time interval. So you know, see, like the products are, as I told you, manufactured in one time and it is sold at another time. So there is a gap between these two times. So the product has to be stored in a proper place. So for that, warehousing is used. Okay, storage or warehousing, or even the products which are brought in. If you go see like in a market, there are people are there, so they are bringing the products and they are keeping in their store. You know, they have store room inside, so they will be keeping. Like if you go to a cloth shop, they will not show all the products outside. They cannot keep or display all the products there. They will display few products there, and remaining things they will keep in their store room. You know. So when it is over, then they bring it. Or if a customer is coming and if they wants to try more products, then they will bring it from their storeroom. Isn't it? So warehousing is very much important. So these are the different factors affecting, or we can say the different functions of marketing. Okay. The next topic that we have to study is about the marketing management philosophies. Different philosophies or different ideologies are there. Every company can have different ideas or philosophy. For example, a particular company can have its idea or philosophy that if the production is done on a large scale, the cost would be less and the product would be sold automatically. In this way, such a company will concentrate mainly on the large scale production of goods. Similarly, some other company can have different ideas. So different companies will have different ideas or different philosophies or different methods are there. Okay, so let us see, there are different types of philosophies. Let us discuss about the philosophies. The first one is called a production concept. Those companies who believe in the philosophy think that the goods and services are cheap and they can be made available at many places, there cannot be any problem regarding sale. So here these people, production concept means that if the products are cheap, low price, then we can easily sell the product. Okay, so that is the technology or the concept or idea of these type of people. And what they think is that they will try to produce the product in a very large quantity. Okay, so if we are able to produce the product in a very large quantity, if large production is done, then cost of production will be very much less. So we can produce the product in a less amount of price, and we can sell the product in a low price. So but nowadays you can see that the people are not just worried about the price, they also think about the quality. Not just thinking about if like a product is available in a low price, simply people will not purchase. If it is up to the mark, if up to quality is there, then only they will purchase the product. The next one is called the product concept. These companies who believe in this philosophy are of the opinion that the quality of goods and services of a good standard, the customers can be easily attracted. The basis of this thinking is that the customers get attracted towards the product of good quality. On the basis of this philosophy, these companies direct their marketing efforts to increase the quality of their product. So second, the product concept means that if the company is having good quality product, if the quality of the product is very good, then people will be automatically purchasing the product. Like you can say like Apple mobile phones. So Apple company, they think that they don't have any compromise in quality. They want to produce the product in a very high quality. Okay, they are giving very high quality services. And related to the price, they don't consider about producing the product in a low price. So people are interested to get a good quality, so they are ready to pay any amount of money for that. So that type of belief is there. So these people think that a product concept is people, they think that If you produce the product in a very good quality and sell it, then people will be ready to purchase it, whatever may be the price, they don't go bother. Okay, this is the another concept. The next concept is that the selling concept. Those companies who believe in this concept think that leaving alone the customers will not help. Instead, there is a need to attract the customers towards them. They think goods are not bought but they are to be sold. The basis of this thinking is that the customers can be attracted. Keeping in view this concept, these companies concentrate their marketing efforts towards educating and attracting the customers. In such a case, their main thinking is selling what you have. Okay, so in this concept, they don't think that these people consider selling concept. They consider that the quality of the product is not going to be a matter, or the price of the product is not going to be a matter, but what type of a selling method that we are using. If you motivate the person, if you make the person believe that this product is very high quality product, even if the product is not of high quality, but make the person believe that this product is of very high quality, then they will be able to sell the product. Okay, so motivating the people to purchase it. Okay, so that is the work of this type of concept. So somehow we have to make the person to purchase the product. So we are giving offers. See, like sometimes in online and all, we are getting so many offers, you know. So buy one, get one free. Very, very highly branded products are coming in a very low price. So people will be getting attracted towards it and people will purchase it. But it will not be of that quality, will not be there, and the price will be, which we are paying, maybe more. But we will not purchase next time, you know. But these people, they consider that if you use better selling methods, then we will be able to sell whatever product that they are having. The next concept is called a marketing concept. Those companies who believe in this concept are of the opinion that success can be achieved only through consumer satisfaction. The basis of this thinking is that only those goods, services should be made available which the customers wants or desire, and not the things which you can do. In other words, they do not sell what they can make, but they make what they can sell. Okay, keeping in this mind idea, these companies direct their marketing efforts to achieve the customer satisfaction. So marketing concept, this concept, the main purpose is to achieve the satisfy the needs of the customers. So first of all, we want to understand what is the need of the customer and make the product according to the needs of the customer. Okay, so it is not simply like make anything and sell it, not like that, but make the product which we can sell. Okay, which is the need of the customer, which is the requirement of the customer. First we have to understand the requirement of the customer, then we have to sell the product. Do you understand? So such a way we will be able to achieve the requirement of the people, or we can achieve a high quality sales. Okay, so we have to make the product, understand the need of the customer, make the product according to the need of the customer, and give the product to them and satisfy their needs. Okay, then next one, this is the latest concept, that is societal marketing concept. This concept stress not only on the customer satisfaction but also gives importance to consumer welfare or social welfare. This concept is also almost a step further than the marketing concept. Under this concept, it is believed that mere satisfaction of consumers would not be help, but welfare of the whole society has to be kept in mind. So in this concept, the companies think that they have to satisfy the needs of the customers as well as they have to satisfy the need of the society also. Okay, not only just to satisfy, see, like once we satisfy the customer, but we have to satisfy the social needs also. So social needs also has to be kept in mind. See, like if we are making a product, this product will be satisfying the customers as well as this product should be satisfying the society also. Okay, so they should produce the product in a very good quality. They should not use any kind of wrong products there, and they should also see to it that the product has a very high quality and they don't make any pollution, you know. So type of pollution or polluting the environment or creating any kind of disturbance for the people, those who are around, and all these type of things should not be there. And they also try to do some kind of social activities like helping the poor and giving educational facilities to the people around them, or giving healthcare facility to the people around the factory. All these type of social activities also they are engaged in. Okay. So there are there's a comparative study is given about all these five philosophies are there, different philosophies are there, different concepts are there, and different comparison is given, like a starting point from where it is starting and from where it is ending. All these type of things is given there. You can just go through it and understand it. Okay.